Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Today in this video we are going to understand about Tesca's Tri-Characteristics Trainer Kit. So through this trainer kit one can understand the different behaving of a triac in different modes and different regions. We will also find out the voltage and current characteristics of a triac, and we will also plot the graph through the manual after taking the reading. So first of all, I will give you a brief description about TRIAC. The TRIAC is a 3-terminal 5-layer device, which is a semiconductor device that can be acts as a power switch to control the alternating current. So TRIAC is triggered into conductions by gate signal in a manner similar to the action of SCR. So now we will move on to the experiment section, and we will perform different experiments which are given in the manual. First, we will describe the kit and different parts of this kit. So this is our kit for Tri-Characteristics Trainer, and the order code for this kit is 36166. So these are the different parts of this kit. Now we will start with this DC current meter. This is the DC current meter which works in dual action. In the 20 milliampere mode and the 200 milliampere mode, in both mode the meter is observe the current and shows the display at this. This is the DC volt meter of 0 to 2 volt and 200 volt. It will also works in both the mode, in 2 volt and 200 volt also. Now this is the DC current meter which works on DC 0 to 200 milliamperes. So this is in the single mode. Now we move on to the power supply. So this is the 70 volt power supply at 100 milliamps DC power supply, which will be provided to TRIAC circuit. And this is the total TRIAC circuit, which consists some components which are resistance by potentiometers. And this is the power supply to provide the gate supply at 0 to 3 volt at 30 milliampere. Now this is our also AC supply. As we know, the TRIAC works on AC and DC both, so we will provide 60 volt 100 milliamps AC power supply to this from this section, and this section also provide AC supply to gate pulse around 7 volts at 30 milliamperes. So this is basic power on off switch of this kit, and these are the 10k potentiometer, and this is the 100k potentiometer, and this is the 220k potentiometer, which are included in this circuit every time which we want. And this is also a switch to bypass the DPM while working with the TRIAC. We will use it later through the experiments. We also provide some patch codes to do the experiments and a user manual to give the detailed experiments descriptions. So now we will move on to the different experiments which are provided in this manual. So we will do some of the experiment to show how to work at this trainer kit. So now we will do the first experiment, which is to study the gate characteristic of TRIAC in different modes. So TRIAC works in different modes. These are the different modes described in this manual. This is mode I plus, mode I minus, and mode 3 plus and 3 minus. So these are the different modes which works in different quadrants. So for first mode, the TRIAC T2 will be positive with respect to T1 and gate positive with respect to T1. So for this we will map the circuit diagram as given in the user manual. For this we will start making the connections with these patch codes. So first we will connect 0 to 70 volt power supply positive to this positive terminal, negative to this negative or ground terminal. Now we will connect the DC voltmeter which is given in this trainer module. So this is the 0 to 2 volt digital multimeter or DPM, which will be connected to observe the VG voltage, which is the gate voltage. And now we will connect the gate power supply positive to the positive at this end, and negative of this supply at this end. Now we will add the current meter. For this we will give positive to the positive as described in the circuit diagram and negative to the negative. Now our circuit connections has been done. First verify the connection before power on the switch or trainer kit, so you will prevent the damages of any components of this kit. First verify properly that your connections has been proper or not. Now we will power on this circuit. Before power on the circuit, make sure the power supply 70 volt and the 3 volt power supply both the side will be at the zero position and the resistance at the anti-clockwise positions. Now we will power on this supply. So after power on the circuit, we will increase the VTT supply. This is the triac voltage around 70 volt, which is the full voltages from this side. And now gradually increase this VGI supply. So this is the gate supply to the triacs. Now as we increase this supply, we will observe both the IG current and the VG voltage and note down this voltage and current in different steps like this. Both the values are shown at DPM. Take down the readings from different steps and plot a graph between VG voltage and IG current. You will find the graph as given in the manual, which is the first quadrant, which is the A graph of triac characteristics, gate characteristics, which is the first quadrant of this. This is the I plus which we have performed here. So this will be graph you observed when you plot a graph after taking down the readings. So this is the first mode of this triac, which is T2 positive with respect to T1 and gate positive with respect to T1. Now there are some different modes in which you just need the same connection from the connection diagram. Also we just need to change the polarity of this VTT and VGT supplies. So after changing the polarity, take down the readings of VG and VTT, sorry IG, and you plot the graph. You will find the all the quadrants from this experiment. So now we move on to the second mode operation of this triac. For this we will provide T2 to the positive with respect to T1 and gate positive with respect to T1. So we will do the circuit connections. For this we connect positive of this to positive. This is the VTT supply and negative of this TT supply will be connected to the negative. Now moving on, we will connect DPM here to observe the VG voltage, and we will connect VGI supply. Now in this mode we will give the negative polarity that we have give positive polarity to the gate terminals. In this mode we will give negative polarity, so positive will be connected here and negative will be connected here. And now negative will be connected with the negative of this current DPM and positive will be connected at this point. So these are the connections which we have made up. Now we will Make sure the both the supply power terminals or port are at the zero position and the minimum position before power on the supply. Check the connections that the connections are made properly or not. Now after verifying the connections, we will power on this circuit. So we will power on the trainer kit and give the 70 volts to this circuit through this potentiometer of power supply, 70 volts. Now we gradually increase the VG and take the readings of VG voltage and IG current, of which is the gate current. So slowly increase this potentiometer. You will find the VG in negative and IG in positive. So in steps, take down all the readings. Here you can see slightly the current increase exponentially from 11 to 25 volts around here. So after taking down all the readings in steps, take some 10 or 20 readings till you get the voltage in the 200 milliampere range. So after taking the readings, when you plot the graph, you will find the graph as per the theoretical graph which is given in the manual. So this is the I minus quadrants graph of mode 2 of this tri-characteristics trainer kit, and the characteristics of triac will be defined as the graph. So you can also do the experiment similarly, finding and changing the polarity of positive VTT and VGI supplies, and the rest of two modes will be doing the same experiment. You will take the VG and IG readings in the both experiment, and you will find all the quadrants and all the modes and plot the graph after taking the reading. So now we will move on to the next experiment. So now we will do the second experiment, which is to study the terminal characteristics of a triac in the different modes. So we will do the one mode for the circuit diagram and interconnections of this diagram is shown at here. Now we will do the rest of the connections. For this, we will provide positive supply of this 70 volt to this DPM section, and negative to the negative. We also connect DPM from this positive and negative terminal. So this will give the IT current here. So we will connect the current DC current meter here of 200 milliampere range. Now we will connect DPM to measure the terminal voltage of triacs. Also, we will connect the gate supply VGI in positive polarity in this mode, which is the mode I plus or first plus, and we will connect the DPM to measure the IG current also. So that's how our connection has been done. So now our connection has been done. Make sure this S1 switch is in off position while doing the experiment and taking the current from IT or the terminal current. And when we connect this DPM here, so this switch should be in off position, so there is no bypass provided to this multimeter, DC current meter. Now we will power on the circuit and give this terminal voltage to the triac terminals around 70 volts. So we will give this the 70 volts voltage DC to the terminal of this triac. So this is almost 70 volts current here. Now we will slowly increase the VGT and we will see the increment in the IG, and we will also see the terminal current will slightly goes forward, and this will be shown the breakover current of this triac. So as I increasing the VGT, after some specified voltage you will see and positive slightly current here. You can see the current start in positive, it's around minus 4 milliampere. So at this time note down the voltage, and you also observe that the terminal voltage goes very low at this time. So this is the breakover condition of this triac. At this time note down all the readings in this observation table given in the user manual. So this is the first breakover current. Here we will mention all the reading at this breakover time. Now we will decrease the IT, which is the terminal current. Through this potentiometer of 10k, and now as we move this potentiometer you will observe that the IT current and the VT voltage, terminal voltage, will changes. So note down the readings through the current in respect of current of by moving this 10k potentiometer, and note down these readings in the observation table given here, VT and IT, and also measure the IG and mention this at this time. The IG will be remain same, and just note down VT and IT in the observation table. Now to close this transistor or the triac, just push this button. Before pushing this button off, so just decrease the VG voltage to zero and push this button to turn off the triac, and change this value of triac to around 50 volts and release this, and again decrease the potentiometer also. Now increasing this value, we will again find the terminal current, breakdown current, and now we'll again take down the readings at 50 volts. Similarly repeat these steps to 50 volts, 60 volts again, and note down the readings in observation table. So this is the second experiment which we have performed, and note down the terminal characteristics of this triac. Now we move on to the next experiment, which is to measure the holding current IH of a triac. So the circuit diagram is given here, and the connection will be doing the with this observing this circuit. So we will do the connections using this page code. For this we will provide positive supply at this terminal of triac and negative to the negative terminal of this 70 volt DC supply. We will also add the DPM to measure the terminal current here like this, and make sure the switch is at off position, this toggle switch, and Now we will connect DPM here to measure the terminal voltage of the track. And also connect the gate supply, which is the 0 to 3 volt power supply in the polarity of same mode. Now we will connect DPM to measure the gate current. So these are our connection for this circuit diagram that had been done. Now before power on the circuit, just make sure and verify all the connections. So now after verifying all the connections, we will power on this circuit. So after power on, just provide full voltage, which is 70 volt DC, to the terminals of the triac. So we have provided here 65 volts. Now slowly increase the VG so the triac will show the terminal current IT in the flow. So this will indicate that the triac is on. So after increasing the voltage, you can see here is the voltage around current of terminal, which is 4.4 milliamps right now. Now we will slowly decrease this current to 1 milliamps by rotating this 10k potentiometer. So this is now 1 milliamps. For lower the reading of this, we will first on this switch and change the range so our triac will not goes in off position. Now we will decrease this 1 milliamps current to 0. So after decreasing all the potentiometer, the current note goes going to 0. For this we will now decrease the current through this power supply. Decreasing the power supply, we will see at a time the current goes 0. So this is the holding current at which this voltage, the current is extremely goes 0. Now we will move on to the next experiment, which is to study the following application of triac. So we will study the triac as an static switch in DC control and control of AC with AC signal. So we will first do the supply connections as per the circuit diagram given in the user manual. For this we will connect positive to this 10k potentiometer and negative of this, sorry, for this we will use the AC supply. So this is the 60 volt AC supply here we provide to this triac. So we can operate this triac by DC control for AC supply. And again we will, in second experiment of this study, we will do the same from the AC supply triggering source. For this we will connect here the DC supply. Before that we will first observe the input waveform of this signal. So we will require an oscilloscope to observe the waveform of input terminals. So now connect the positive and negative of the CRO probe to the terminals of the triac. Now we will power on the circuit and slowly increase the, sorry, here we not required to increase the voltage as the fixed voltage of 60 volt power supply are provided AC supplies. So this is our sine wave, which is showing at CRO. Now we will provide the gate control or DC control supply. For this, switch off this kit and connect the positive and negative terminal of this gate control circuit or supply. Now as we see, as I give the supply to the terminals, the waveform shows the positive half has been clipped for a fraction of seconds. After adjusting the current or voltage of VG supply, you will able to find out the waveform shown in the manual. Like this. So in the CRO you will see the waveform as per the user manual, that the shaded waveform slightly goes down sine waveform before clipping. So this is the DC control of an AC signal. Here you can see this waveform is going down as I increase and decrease the power supply. So the positive half is clipped here. Now we will do the next mode for this, which is the last practical to study the application of TRIAC in control of AC with an AC signal. So for this we will provide AC supply to this TRIAC module and also control this TRIAC module by an AC supply. So for this we will connect first the AC supply to this 10K potentiometer here. Sorry, this is the AC supply and this is the negative here for AC supplies. And now we will observe the waveform similarly that we have observed in earlier practical. For this we will connect the CRO probes to the terminals and now we will power on the circuit and you will see the sine wave at the CRO. Now we will control this signal by AC power signal which is provided at this kit. So we will connect negative to negative and positive to positive of this circuit. Now we will power on the circuit and you can see the waveform of sine wave at the CRO. I will increase the volts per division of this wave so we will observe the proper output. Now we will control this AC signal or IG current by controlling and increasing and decreasing the 100K potentiometer. For this, as I move this 100K potentiometer slightly, you will observe the changes in waveform, output waveform or terminal waveform. Here you can see the waveform changes. These changes are also shown in the user manual. So you can see the waveforms which are also given in the CRO. Same here, as I increase the horizontals volts per division, you can observe the shaded wave as described in the manual. We will also getting the same waveform as I changes the 100k potentiometer, the waveform vary as per the gate current varies through this potentiometer. So that's how we control the AC terminal of triac by giving the AC power supply, and we will controlling it this by an AC signal. So that's how we control the triac and describe the different characteristics of this triac. So that's how we perform different experiment to understand the triac characteristics with this triac characteristics trainer kit. While performing the experiments, if you find any difficulties, you can easily contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited or go through our website for all the supports. Thank you for today.